Hello. This is not a particularly exciting setup. There's a white wall. There's a black futon. There's me. But what is exciting is that I'm back at college. I've become very erratic on this channel. I think we're just gonna have to embrace it. At this point, I'm shooting for like one video a month. That's the vision. Hi, no apologies. No intro. Here we go. I've talked extensively. Or I feel like I've talked extensively. I've mentioned at least once that I'm gonna be, and now am, my floor's Barnabas. And I think I've explained what that is, but who knows in what video or where. So that's a member of Calvin College's Community Life Council. It's like someone who walks with the floor in terms of the spiritual well-being and particular, like, plans events for that, and is supposed to be available to help people with questions related to spirituality. There's the fire alarm. We're going to talk through it. It's not someone who has the answers, all of them. It's not, like, necessarily someone who's a religion major, though I am. It's not, like, someone who lives a perfect life. It does not necessarily have to be cisgender, heterosexual, because I came out in my interview and they hired me anyway. So, hello, friends, who you may or may not be able to hear, but I hear through my window, which is open. When we went to training, one of the things they talked about was how we are supposed to live our lives in a way that helps our floor, which makes sense. But, like, because we're supposed to be, like, people, our floor, community, and other people, I guess, can come to if they have spiritual questions or doubts or whatever. We're supposed to live, and we're also supposed to be, like, spiritual leaders in our communities. Not only are we, like, not supposed to really sin, I mean, like, everybody sins, but, like, we shouldn't, but our chaplain told us that we are supposed to live above even the appearance of reproach. There's some Bible passage somewhere in the New Testament, in like Acts or one of Paul's letters, where he says, he's either Luke if it's Acts or Paul if it's one of Paul's letters, but where the author is like, first of all, you shouldn't sin, but second of all, you shouldn't do the things that aren't sins in your walk, but would cause those around you to sin, or would make them think you are sinning, because that's gonna cause tension in the community, and that's not necessary. So he talks about, like, eating meat that's been sacrificed to idols. It's not necessarily a sin, but if other people interpret it as a sin, don't do it, because it's not worth it, even if it's cheaper. So, like, they talked about how we shouldn't curse, and we should dress modestly, and how we should abstain from same-sex relationships. To be clear, they did not give us these guidelines when we signed our contracts, and we're like, yeah, we will do this job, and we will be here on the day that we should show up for training. They told us this after we'd committed, after we'd moved in, after we'd already started training. I'm like, on one hand, okay, you don't tell everyone everything about the job. And sure, everyone's been being held to the same expectation, and sure, like, if someone started dating someone of the same sex, it probably wouldn't stop being a Barnabas, because it's really hard to prove what dating looks like, and you could keep it on the DL, and, like, you know, there are all these things that you could justify this through, but this is less about that and more about how I am feeling in regards to all of this and my thoughts with, like, what even does the same-sex relationship look like for a non-binary person? So part of me wants to go talk to, like, our head chaplain, who is not my boss. My boss is our assistant chaplain. One of three assistant chaplains. I could talk to him too, but I could talk to him too. So part of me wants to talk to our chaplain and be like, what would a same-sex marriage look, or relationship look like for marriage? But what would a same-sex romantic relationship look like for me as a non-binary person? In the CRC's eyes, in Calvin's eyes, in your eyes, whatever. Because you, this, for some reason, the first video you're watching. Hello, welcome to my channel. Also, I'm non-binary. Also, Calvin College is where I go to school. Also, Calvin College is the flagship school of the Christian Reformed Church. CRC. They, don't, like, same-sex relationships or marriage or anything. That's, now you're up to speed. But I have a feeling, I could be wrong, but I have a feeling that she would tell me that the CRC would define a same-sex relationship based upon the gender I was assigned at birth. I'm like, that's fine for the CRC to do. It's, I don't care. Because I know that's not what's relevant. What's relevant is my gender identity or lack thereof of one. Like, I fully recognized that I was assigned a gender at birth that has no reflection on my identity. None whatsoever. I recognize that there are certain body characteristics that I have in common with the vast majority of people who were assigned the same gender at birth that I was. We have similar traits. Cool, cool, cool. Doesn't mean a thing. So I reject that out of hand. But I have a feeling that's what they'd say, and so they'd be like, well, Joe. And I'd be like, well, no. And they'd be like, well, no. And I'd be like, this is a real confusing conversation. I don't know how we got here. So they'd be like, well, don't date girls. So, they tell me I could date guys. And maybe non-binary people who are not assigned the same thing I was at birth. And I feel like this is not an acceptable framework for me because it doesn't make sense to me. So I am in this weird place where I don't want to break the rules. I don't want to do something that will, like, get me kicked off. And I also very, very strongly want to be an RA next year. It's something I wanted to do this year, but, you know, things work out differently than we expect a lot, and I'm very, very happy to be doing what I'm doing now. So, but I guarantee I will have the same rules as long as I'm anyway involved with the Community Life Council, which ours are a part of, kind of. So. I have recently been thinking a lot about, I'm gonna misuse this word, but for like thinking a lot about like temporary celibacy or something. And I know celibacy is like supposed to refer to like sexual activity. That's not what I mean. I mean like abstaining from all romantic relationships while I am serving in a Community Life Council leadership position at Calvin College, because I think it makes it simpler than having to like sort through what is a same-sex relationship, what is an opposite-sex relationship, what is acceptable in the Community Life Council's eyes, or like the people who oversee them, what can I live with. It gives me just like a one-size-fits-all framework for this year, maybe the next year, possibly the year after that. I don't think so. For this year and maybe the next. But, like, that seems lonely. And it's not fair. It's not fair to me. It's not fair to any other trans and non-binary Community Life Council members. It's not fair to any other LGBT Community Life Council members in general, whether they are polysexual, which is casual for like pan, bi, poly, like anyone who is attracted to more than one gender. Like, all of those sexualities fall under polysexual. It's not fair to any of us that we have to, like, analyze our attractions and be like, which of these is okay, and which of these isn't, and which of these is allowed, and which of these isn't. And it's not fair to gay and lesbian members of the Community Life Council that anything they feel is not to be acted upon. Because there are people on this campus, all kinds of people, who like make my heart happy. But what's the point of, like, talking about it if you can't act on it because of whatever? And it's so weird, because at the end of the day, it's like, we worship a god whose main thing is love, and we can't embrace love. But whatever, that's an argument for another. Those are my most recent thoughts. But I'm so excited to be a part. I don't want to be lonely while I'm being a part. So if anyone has any feedback, whether you're on campus, off campus, if somehow you've been in the same situation, particularly, feel free to hit me up, either here or any other number of avenues. And I hope you have a great day.